my name is Ben, and this is the Moss Report. We're on location in Tijuana, Mexico, in the downtown area. And right now we're visiting the Functional Oncology and Immunotherapy Institute, and we'll be speaking with Dr. Ariel Perez, the medical director. The medical industry in Tijuana is remarkably robust and active. There are all kinds of buildings that are entirely dedicated to medical procedures, and it's not just like here and there there's a hospital. There's clinics and hospitals pretty much everywhere you go around in Tijuana. And Dr. Perez, I believe, is actually the medical director for a couple of different programs. I'm going to try to get some clarity around that topic and other things relating to his scientific philosophy as we connect him with Dr. Ralph Moss and have those conversations about the science and philosophy behind his treatment methodology. So we'll be meeting first with Mike Barajas, Dr. Perez's associate, and he'll be, I guess, taking us on a tour of the facility, and we'll have a look around and see what they have here.
I met your dad many, many years, around 20 years ago, I started working in the field with Dr. Contreras. So I worked
for
Oasis like 20-something years
ago.
I was a regular at the Cancer Control Society convention. So I got to meet your dad and chat with your dad.
Oh, well, that's nice. Times. Oh, is that
and
right?
It was probably around 14 years ago that I opened my own center along with Dr. Perez.
I see. Oh, I see. Okay.
So back when I was at Oasis, I was a regular at the Cancer Control Society. I'm very good friends with Frank and everyone there.
Sure. Wow. So you've been around.
Yes. I started with Dr. Contreras probably around 23 years ago.
Wow.
Something like that.
You seem like such a young man to have had that much history.
I got to meet a lot of the pioneers. Mrs. Issels was a wonderful person, and we got to work with her quite closely. Past 10 years probably, not like 8 years, all of the Issels patients were actually treated by my team.
I see.
They still are. So when you see a patient that is receiving the Issels treatment, they're actually being treated at my center.
I see.
We started collaborating with Mrs. Issels around 8 years ago, and then I know that she recently passed away, but we continue to collaborate with Christian.
Right.
Okay, so I'm going to give you a little tour. This is like a common area. Every day we do have a catering service that works closely with our clinical nutritionist, and every patient has a personalized diet. So every patient that comes in will have the breakfast, lunch and dinner right here set up for the patients so they can grab, they have their names and it's tagged. So this is like a common area. Some of the patients do like to sit around in one of these zero gravity chairs and have a massage while they're getting their IVs. But we're gonna head over this side. This is one of the treating rooms as well. That is actually an equipment that was made to us specifically from a company in Italy called Imperium. And this is a localized hyperthermia equipment. It's a pinpoint electrohyperthermia equipment that can go all the way down to the bone and heat a specific part of the body within a millimeter. So this is done for localized hyperthermia specifically. This one here is the hyperthermia pump for the systemic perfusion. Obviously, we don't do the systemic perfusion hyperthermia treatment here. That is done downstairs in one of the ORs. So you're getting a little bit of the behind the scenes while it's not in action. This is the nursing station, and this is where most of our patients actually spend most of the day at getting their IVs. One of the things that we develop, which I believe is very cool, whenever a patient is getting an IV, there's a little QR code that the patient can scan with their phones. And that QR code is gonna take them to a video that explains what they're getting, why they're getting it, what it synergizes with, and what are the top 5 benefits that we're aiming to achieve with that IV. Where the patient is getting a dendritic cell, it'll give them a video on what dendritic cells are, why we use them, how we obtain them, and what are we trying to achieve with dendritic cells in his case. And it's a very unique way, because yes, the doctors will tell them that you're getting vitamin C, and some patients will ask why, some won't, and some will just say, oh, okay, and don't really understand. And we've made the videos in a way that is just very easy to digest and for the patient to hear why we're doing what we're doing and why are they getting that IV. And specifically when we do the immunotherapy, they get pumped because they start visualizing the immunotherapy working to attack malignant cells. And you can just see it in their face when they see the video that they get hyped, they get excited, you know? They say, I'm feeling these guys coming in and attacking the cancer cells in my body.
That's amazing. Providing an opportunity for the patient to visualize what's actually happening and why, I can imagine, leads to a positive attitude.
Exactly, yes. And is down here, let's go. Well, we have doctor's offices here, and we have the transdermal. This is where we do the transdermal ozone, and we do systemic and other chemotherapy ozone as well. So it's our little quick tiny center here, and we're very happy. I mean, one of the main reasons why we decided to open the outpatient in addition to the inpatient program is because a lot of the patients that we get are actually, they don't need to be hospitalized. So when we had the patient in a hospital setting, it was just like spending the night in a very, very expensive hotel because they did not need the hospital infrastructure behind it. One of the biggest benefits that we obtain by doing the outpatient is that we are able to offer a base 3-week program at around 40% less than what a 2-week program would cost us an inpatient at the hospital. So that was a savings that we could pass on to our patients. Not only are they getting more treatments, but they're spending around 40% less than what they were or what they would had they have to do inpatient scenario.
They're spending the money on the treatment.
Not on a very, very expensive hotel room. So I think that's really just about it. We're going to have a little meeting here. You're going to get to meet Dr. Perez and my other partner, Carlos Zavala.
Good. Okay.
This is Carlos Zavala. He's one of the co-founders of the center.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well.
What is your name?
My name is Ben Moss.
Hi, Ben. How are you?
And this is my wife, Elizabeth.
Hi, Elizabeth. Nice to meet you.
The CEO of the program, the administrative CEO.
Okay, I understand.
The following segment is an edited version of the full clinic conversation available at themossreport.com.
Welcome. My name is Miguel Barajas. I'm one of the co-founders of the Immunotherapy Institute, and I handle the day-to-day operations. I'm glad to have you guys here.
Thank you. Welcome. I'm Dr. Ariel Perez. I am the medical director of the Immunotherapy Institute. I'm also the founder and creator of the program that we have here.
Thank you. My name is Carlos Zavala. I am the chief operating officer for the Institute. We want to welcome you and thank you for the opportunity to express.
Well, it's good to see you all. I met Dr. Perez at the Angeles Hospital.
That's correct.
Just when they were starting out. I think I was like the first day or something. Since you started and since we've spoken, immunotherapy has gone to the forefront of cancer treatment. It's really become the fourth modality. So I guess the question is, how does your program differ from what people are being offered in their home states, in their home hospitals?
So let's recapitulate. Yes. So immunotherapy is, as you mentioned, an established form of treatment and modality within the oncological field. Immunotherapy is not exclusively of the oncological field. As you know, it's other disciplines within the medical field in which relying in immunotherapy. Immunotherapy is using my immune system to fight, in this case, cancer, right? And why? Well, because my immune system is involved in the situation as the system that is controlling any form of development of any defective, useless cell. Let's call it that. So my immune system, the fact that we have the disease, has failed, right? And this is one of the reasons why we have cancer. As you know, there's many reasons that we need to explore, from genetics to even the psychological part. But specifically talking about the immunotherapy part, or immune system part, we have a dysfunction of lack of recognition. And in this case, we're not mounting, or the immune system is not mounting, the proper immune response against the disease. Traditionally speaking, somebody else is taking the place of your immune system in a form of chemotherapy, radiotherapy, or surgery, which continue to be treatments within the oncological field. But this treatment goes more in tune with the systems, let's say, that the body has in check to fight this kind of condition. So immunotherapy comes in two modalities, talking about advantages and what are those differences that we have, let's say, with these places, renowned places in the States, is availability of these technologies since day one. And I don't deny that I speak with more patients every day that are receiving some form of immunotherapy, but I'm sorry to say, Dr. Moss, that is not the first thing that they receive. Still, because of other reasons, mostly because insurance, they are forced to go through chemo, radiation sometimes, before the door of immunotherapy is open. So that's one of the advantages that we have here. You don't have to go through those previous treatments that right now are not achieving the same results as with immunotherapy. There's no need. So that's number one advantage. Second, availability of the differences between those treatments. Immunotherapy comes in two modalities. One, medications that push my immune system to fight the disease. And here we can place all of the different medications in that area, from checkpoint inhibitors, monoclonal antibodies, you name it, right? At the end, this is the area of immunotherapy as well. This is the most personalized part of medicine right now in the oncological field. It doesn't get more personalized than this. And then we have the other phase of immunotherapy, which is the phase of the cells, right? They work directly with the T cell population. And as you know, we have been pioneers on this technology for almost now 20 years, I will say. And the end result is the availability to work with both technologies, the T cells along with the medications.
So I want to know, how have you made a breakthrough in terms of the treatment of more common solid tumors of adults? Have you made a breakthrough in the creation of CAR T cell?
Well, this is the present of what we envisioned, you know, many years ago, of being able to manipulate the cells even more to the benefit of the patient or the situation. And that's what CAR T therapy brings to the table. Just as a historical antecedent, so all of this revolution actually started in solid tumors. Almost 30 years ago with Provenge, it's how everything started, and it was for prostate cancer. Of course, we can have mixed comments about the success or not success. I always will put a question mark on those results based on the moment in which many of those patients were reaching that technology, and what was the condition in which many of those patients were receiving the cells at that point, you know, which was not cancer, at my point of view. Nevertheless, you're right. For some reason, this type of technology started to migrate into the hematological disorders, or what we know as blood cancers. But again, I want to emphasize that everything started with a population of solid tumors. And our experience with treatment of solid tumors with cells is immense. And the results are there. I cannot say it's specifically for that, because you know we use an integrative approach. But it's obvious that this is the treatment that has the biggest weight and foundation. We have already populations of patients with hematological disorders that are responding successfully, of course. And we just started, in this case, with the CAR T and solid tumors with a population of the most common cancers, such as breast cancer, colorectal cancer, and maybe lung cancer for now. I still don't understand how it is that in the States they get to those prices or those numbers. And because when we are working with this technology, we're talking about completely different numbers. And with all due respect, I really don't understand how is that such a treatment, which I understand is the most advanced, gets to that point of price, you know? So I'm going to leave this to my colleagues, but in relation to the technology, we are starting, we have been sick actually by many people with pancreatic carcinoma for CAR T therapy. And this is because there's two trials taking place right now. I think one is in San Diego and the other one is in Portland, in which they're using CAR T therapy.
It's been a real pleasure to sit down and meet with you all and talk with you and to have you reconnect with Dr. Moss.
Thank you. Thank you for allowing us to explain how is that we help patients, how is that we work. It is our passion. You know, we are committed to what we do here, and we believe that we have something special, you know, and we want to share it with the world.